We're gonna tear your kingdom down. Oh, no.
We're gonna tear your kingdom down. You've been building your kingdom. Satan, we're gonna take you kingdom now.
Oh, thank you, Lord. The freedom
is gonna reach your kingdom now.
You better watch out now, Satan.
For the preacher, preach your kingdom now. You've been. Your kingdom now. Kingdom now.
Oh, you better watch out now, Satan.
Mothers is gonna pray your kingdom. You've been. Oh, hallelujah. We're gonna tear your kingdom now.
Oh, Satan,
we're gonna tear
your kingdom down. You better watch out now.
Satan, we're gonna tear your kingdom now. Satan, we're gonna tear you.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, glory to
God. Hey everybody, this is your girl Libra Butterfly coming to you from the great state of Kentucky, where the women are beautiful and the horses are fast. How the horses are beautiful and the women are fast. It just really depends on what you like. I am wanting to wish everybody a birthday who happens to be celebrating a birthday anniversary, bar mitzvah, announcement of a baby, anything you celebrate that is positive, I stand with you. So happy birthday and stuff to Lottie Dottie and everybody. I'm not going to be on here long, but I had to share something with you guys. So, yesterday, Friday evening, I fell, and I mean, I fell hard. All I could do is protect my head, because in my house, I have a big table that my big screen sits on. It's a TV table, but the edges of it is very pointed. Okay. And when I was going down and realized I wasn't going to, you know, come out of it, I did everything I could to protect my head. Right. And stuff. And so, you know, I was sore, really sore. I'm just now trying to really get back to, you know, feeling the way I was feeling, because, you know, that was a hard fall, a very hard fall. And, you know, I'm just grateful, because let me tell you something. I just found out yesterday that one of my cousins, her funeral was yesterday. They couldn't reach all the family. So those that they couldn't reach in time to make it to the funeral, they called us. I put it in the family group and everybody spread it the word, because I told you I have a very big family. And I asked, how did she pass away? You know, and my mother told me that her dad told my mother that she fell. Come on, God. That she fell getting out of the tub and never regained consciousness. And the only reason why she lived as much as she did is because she had signed her organ donor card, and they needed to get her organs out. Because once you shut down, they have to fight against the clock. So they kept her on the ventilator just to get her organs out. Y'all, my mama said, because she knew I fell, you know, and my mama said that when she heard that, after she told her cousin, you know, she gave her her condolences, she said, but what went through her mind when she found out how my little cousin died, my mother said she just immediately started praising God. She said, because it could have been two for one. She said, and when I hung up from him, I really screamed. She said, I screamed, God, thank you. God, hallelujah. Keep protecting my child. Keep protecting my child. You know, like that. And I was like, wow, because it hit me. It hit me. And I was like, oh, my God. You know, and when I say little cousin, I think she's older than me. But, you know, but it dawned on me that my story could have been something different. Instead of me being sore, I actually could have been knocked out in her dead, you know. And I don't take my life for granted. That's why, I just can't let nobody play with me. I just can't. God is so good. He's opened up so many doors for me. He has kept me from a whole lot of stuff. Even during the times when I was, you know, in the world, almost thinking I was going bat doo-doo crazy, he still kept his arms around me. And so, you know, I ain't got to go back 3 and 4 years to tell you no testimony or no praise report of what God did for me. I can just every day. And so, yeah, some of y'all get it. Some of y'all won't. And I'm not trying to convince nobody or nothing. It's my story. This is what happened to me. And the fact that my cousin was just getting out of the tub and fell. And never open up her eyes again. God is good to me. He is so good to me. And so in the midst of me praising God for my survival, I'm also thanking God that she didn't suffer. You know, so I had to come on her and give God glory and tell y'all another yet thing that I've been through. Let me go a little bit deeper than that. So, I told y'all strange things happened to me, been happening to me since I was a kid. Okay. So two nights in a row, the first night what happened to me, I was laying in the bed. I was knocked. I mean, knocked. Do you hear me? And all of a sudden it was like a cat had jumped on my bed and it woke me straight up, right? Because I know I don't have no cat in the house, right? So, you know, I got to looking around, seeing if anything, you know, looking up under my bed and all this and stuff. And I'm like, what is going on? So I tried to go back to sleep and my bed bumps again. I mean, bump hard enough to move me. And so I opens up my eyes again. I'm like, what is going on? Nothing's in my room. I don't see nothing. Quiet. So one more time, I tries to close my eyes. And all of a sudden, boom, bump on my bed again. So this time, I just try to stay awake. because I'm like, this is crazy. This is crazy. So, okay, nothing else happened. The next night I was in the bed, knocked again, y'all. Felt the presence sit at the bottom of my bed next to my foot. I mean, sit. Like my whole, you know, when somebody sit on the bed, you feel it? My whole bed went down like somebody sat on my bed. And I opened my eyes real quick because I'm not a sound sleeper. So any little noise going to wake me up or whatever, right? So I opens up my eyes and I'm like, I don't see nobody. Nobody. And my son wasn't here. Okay, so I'm like, okay, now this is really becoming strange. This is really becoming strange. So I'm like, okay, let me close my eyes. So I'm going back to sleep and I feel the bed bump again like it did the night before. So I'm waking up again like, what is going on? So immediately I just start praying until I evidently prayed myself to sleep because I woke up feeling refreshed. Okay, third day. I goes out my side door. When I go out my side door and turns to lock my door so I can get in my car, because, you know, I have a thing I pull in and I have a garage too. Well, I was pulling in. I mean, you know, it's right there by the door where I had pulled in the night before. So I comes out, takes the key, and I'm talking to my baby girl on the phone while I'm doing all this, and immediately, this cologne hits me so strong, y'all. I mean, like somebody had just opened up a bottle and dumped it. It hits me so strong. I said, oh my God, this is weird. So baby girl said, you all right, mama? What's going on? You all right? You all right? I said, this is weird. She said, what? I said, your daddy's cologne just circled me. She said, huh? I said, yeah. I said, I walked to the edge of the house, no smell. I walked to the back of the house, no smell. I goes back to stand between my house, my side door of my house and my car. All you smell is my husband. That's all you smell is his cologne. So I'm looking for a bottle and all this and stuff. Like, why do I smell his cologne? And why am I smelling it so strong? Y'all think of playing. It's like if somebody took a bottle of cologne and just pulled it in one spot and you standing there. And wasn't nothing out there. Wasn't no spots, wasn't no nothing. She said, Mama, I really think Daddy's trying to let you know he's still with you. That's what my baby girl said. She said, I really think it's Daddy trying to let you know he's still with you. Y'all, I gets in the car. I'm like, this is weird. This is weird. You know, I'm used to strange things happening to me, but this was weird. And I mean, y'all, that cologne, I never forget the smell of that cologne because he wore that every day for work, every day. I bought him so much cologne, and he had his three extra favorites. And that was one, and he wore it so much, I hated the smell. Seriously. And I'm like, oh, my goodness, y'all. It tripped me out. So, it's weird. So I talked to my professor today and she just got out of surgery and I didn't know that. So I told her, you know, take your time and heal, this will wait. So she's going to get back with me. She said, hopefully by tomorrow. Because, see, I don't claim to know everything. Even though I got degrees and stuff, I don't claim to know everything. Some things is beyond me, you know. And but I'm smart enough to know who to go to if in case I need to know, though. I'm smart enough to do that. And that bothered me, not in a bad way, but the unknown. And it's done piqued my curiosity for real because I know I went to another dimension. Like I ran out of levels. See, you can get so much, you can get so close to God that you run out of levels and he takes you through dimensions. And that's where I've been at for a minute in different dimensions. And I need to know some stuff about this dimension that I'm in. You know, let me tell you this, even with people being sick, and like I can walk past them, I sit next to them and they're no longer sick. So I'm in dimensions now, you know, and God warned me today about watching what I intake, what I take before my eye gates, my ear gates, what I surround myself with, because I am in dimensions. And he ain't got to tell me twice. He ain't got, I'm going to make a whole 360. Well, I'm going to make a whole 180. I don't want to make a whole turn, because then I'd be right back where I'm leaving. So I'm going to make a 180 with some stuff. You know, of course, people are going to have something to say and all this. I don't care. I don't care. Care not. Like I said, the only man that I'm afraid of is God. And once he give me my instructions, it's on and popping, you know. So prophetically, let me reiterate something. I'm gonna say this. If you do not have a credit union, you need to investigate in a credit union and move the majority of your whatever to a credit union. Credit unions are a little bit more different because they're more or less ran by the people. The banks, the banking system, okay, prophetically, what I see is about to crash. I've been kind of warning y'all this, you know, and y'all can believe it or not, it's up to you. But I would at least have a credit union, too, that I put my money in. So, yeah, that's how I'm going to say that, you know, and just to protect myself, I can't say allegedly because God gave it to me, but okay, if I have to, whatever. So, yeah, allegedly. Okay. Yeah, so I would do that, but it's up to you. A lot of y'all hear what I say and y'all don't do it, and then when it happens, y'all like, you said. Okay. And that's another thing I've been working on. I, you know, everybody's grown. I'm going to say what I'm supposed to say, and I'm going to be done with it. Whether you follow the instructions or not, it's up to you. It's up to you. And, honey, you can't call me no more than I'm already used to. Weird, she crazy, blah, 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 blah. Then I ain't talking to you. Keep it moving. See how simple that is? Delgin, I ain't trying to convince nobody of nothing. It just is what it is. Okay? So that's what I wanted to say. Get you an extra gas can and fill it up with gas and don't use it. Put it somewhere cool. Right now, since it's wintertime, it shouldn't be a problem. Put it somewhere cool. You know, yeah. Yeah. And that's all I'm going to say about that. I have not been released to say anything else. Except for this, I know Christmas time is very important to people, especially those with kids. And, you know, you want to make sure that you get, you know, little Tommy, that PlayStation 5 and, you know, all this. And y'all, be smart. Be smart. You know, be careful with your money. Be smart and be careful with your money. I'm not saying not to get people gifts for Christmas. That is not what I'm saying. I would never tell no parent that because, you know, first thing you know, that's my child. You can't tell me what to do with my child. Okay, whatever. You know. And let me say this. I'm going to end with this. Maya Angelou said it best. When people show you who they are, believe them. I have a tendency to see the good in everybody, even when they're stabbing me, even when they're neglecting me, even when they're not being 100 with me, I still choose to see the good in the person, and sometimes to my detriment. I ain't doing that no more. If it walk like a duck and it quack like a duck, it's a dang duck. You know, I'm at the point, no longer am I going to overlook how people treat me. You know, people say one thing and they do another. And I'm like, oh, well, you know, they wasn't trying to. I make excuses for them because, like I said, I try to see the good in everybody. But some people use it as a manipulation. And I'm over it. I ain't God. And I don't have to do it. I don't have to see the best in nobody. And I'm at that point to where, okay, you don't really care for me. You don't really like me. Not for real. And I don't know what you're getting from me that makes you play like you do. So I'm going to draw a line in the sand. Because I love me. You don't love me? What's wrong with you? No, I'm just playing. But anyway, Maya Angelou said it best. When people show you who they are, believe them. All right, y'all. I'm out of here. This has been Libra Butterfly coming to you. And thank you to all my subbies. I love you guys.